A bit of history about the beautiful coastline that is the Gower Peninsula.
I am here on Caswell Bay, one of the many beaches on the Gower Peninsula. For generations, people have come far and wide to enjoy what this peninsula has to offer. Whether you're a surfer, kayaker, photographer, or enjoy walking along beautiful coastline, there is something for everyone here.
During the summer months, the Gower beaches get particularly busy, with tourism playing a huge part. For most people who come to Gower, it's about soaking up the scenery and enjoying the views, with many of the beaches being considered the prettiest in Europe. A survey carried out by TripAdvisor in recent years placed Rosilli Bay in the top 10 beaches in the world, so it is clear why tourists are so attracted to what this peninsula has to offer. There is a lot of history which has taken place on the Gower Peninsula.
During the 18th and early 19th century, smuggling activities were prolific at this time. Goods such as tea, silk, tobacco, and spirits, including brandy and rum, were smuggled from countries like France, Holland, and Ireland. The Gower coastline, with its quiet, secluded bays hidden in the cliffs, were perfect for smuggling.
Beaches across Gower, such as Brandy Cove and Pulte, were heavily used for smuggling. But as well as smuggling, Pulte was used for its limestone.
During the 18th century, limestone was quarried on various locations across South Wales. Pulte in particular was a beach heavily used for its limestone, and you can still find evidence of this today.
Here, you can see where workers used to quarry limestone. Once quarried, the limestone was collected on ships.
Although Pulte is well known for being a more sheltered beach on Gower, during stormy weather conditions and rough sea, any beach around here can be a risk. Just look at all this wood, which has been washed up by Storm Freya only a few days ago.
In 1886, a ship called Agnes ran aground at Whiteshell Point just east of Caswell Bay. And although all crew members went ashore, the ship remained grounded and was destroyed by a storm a week later. Even today, when the tide is out, you can still see remains of the ship's boiler.
There was one shipwreck in particular, which ran aground at Pulte Head in 1760.
This particular ship was called Caesar and was working for the Navy. During this period, it was common for the Navy to hire vessels to scour rural communities and force quarrymen, farmers, and labourers into the Navy at times of war. The Caesar was carrying over 60 press-ganged men. Once the Caesar set off out of Swansea Bay where it had been sheltering, weather conditions were very bad, and the Caesar had no option but to turn back into Swansea. Some say visibility was so poor, the pilot mistook Pulte Head for Mumbles Head. This was 34 years before the lighthouse was built at Mumbles. The Caesar hit rocks at Pulte Head, damaging the hull, and the ship sank. The ship's master and crew managed to swim ashore, but in doing so, leaving those kept below deck, possibly in chains, who were to have no chance of escape. Where the Caesar ran aground is now known as Caesar's Hole. The morning after the shipwreck, locals from Bishopston, Pennard and Pulte recovered over 60 bodies and buried them at Pulte Head. Where they are buried is called Gravesend. You can see Gravesend as it is marked with a circle of stones, and it is most visible during the winter months when vegetation is low.
The Gower is full of stories, tales, and mysteries. Too many to cover in this short video. I hope you join me again soon as I continue my journey around Gower and improve my own understanding of this amazing coastline. Thank you for watching.